this would be a great interviews. Today, I'm gonna call them the fuck interviews. I'm just gonna be fucking around with the crew, with the protesters behind me. A protest. And behind me on the other side, that's like so strange. 180 degrees, another protest. And here we go. Over there, the other protest. There's a red team, there is a green team, and there is a no color team. No color team over there. So let's go check what these people are protesting. Uh-huh. Or maybe they are protesting about the same thing. Excuse me, I'm making an interview for myself. What is the protest? The protest, they are so... Huh? Who is the organizer? That lady? What is it?
The protest is against the animal control of New York.
Animal controls?
Animal shelters of New York City.
Oh! Wait a minute, why? I don't...
They kill the animals.
They kill the animals?
Yes. The shelter's killing like 20 plus animals a day.
Why they would do that?
We're protesting it because...
That's my own channel. There's nothing to do with politics, by the way.
They're trying to make change that they don't kill the animals.
They should not kill the animals.
They do.
Give the animals a chance.
So who's this guy that decides? Do we know a person?
Decides to kill them? Whoever runs the city.
Who runs the city? The mayor? We gotta talk to the mayor. I'm talking about the mayor. Hey, mayor, put the toilets first, you know. I have my own movement, by the way. It's about the toilets. Do you know?
No.
Doesn't make... Don't you feel? What's your name?
Mike.
Huh? Yeah. You're afraid to say your name? My name is Ivan. Ivan. Your name is?
Fran.
Fran. Let's go to my movement now. Mayor de Blasio, we need toilets in New York City.
Oh, toilets?
Yeah.
Okay. There's no toilets in New York City, me outside.
Are you from the moon?
I don't really come to the city. I live on Long Island.
Huh? You walk all over. So where was the restroom using? Which restroom you
use? I haven't gone yet.
So now what's going to happen
Starbucks?
Okay, Starbucks is the public toilet of New York City. That you think it's funny?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, I don't think it's funny either.
It should be public.
You would buy?
No, I buy something and I use a
bathroom. Are you an idiot? I'm sorry, I hurt your feelings. You just heard what you said. I have to buy something to go to the toilet. In my movement, I believe the human person has the right to...
If we had a public restroom, that would be great.
Right.
Someone has to man them.
Yeah. Okay. Is it possible to do that in this great city of New York?
Sure.
So why they don't? So we have to go to Starbucks to pay money for it.
But right now, we're worried about the animals.
Okay, now I want to hear all these points.
Don't kill New York!
I want to know who's the person that decides to kill the animals. There should be a person.
The mayor.
De Blasio.
Yes.
They said that he's the most in what is it?
Inhumane.
No, unhuman. They say is non-capable person of doing anything. Like, you suck.
You want public toilets and we want the animals not to be killed.
All the public say you suck, Mr. De Blasio. I'm sorry if I hurt your feelings, but we have to say that. But I don't think he's the guy for the animals. I don't think he's the guy.
No, not at all.
I think your movement should first decide to find this person, because the things, they don't come from the sky. There is somebody that came up with this stupidity. I don't know if it's stupidity.
Right.
And why the, by the way, I want to ask you, what do you think is the solution? Because I came up with solution already.
And who did you give the solution to?
Nobody. I'm not.
You have to tell the mayor. You have to go to the mayor's office and write the mayor's office.
No. I don't. I will only go for the toilets. But I.
That's what I'm saying.
I have the balls to go to the toilets. Problem directly to him. If he's around, I'm gonna attack him immediately. However, what is your solution for the animals? Do you have one?
Solution?
Yeah.
The solution is to get the mayor.
There's a protest. There is a protest, or there is a solution. So,
the solution is not to kill the animals.
But let's say.
The solution is not to use taxpayers' money to kill animals.
I don't want to talk about money.
No, well,
that has nothing to do with money. Actually, there's a lot to do with money, but I'm asking you as a human being.
The solution is not to kill animals. There's other ways of keeping animals safe.
That's what we want to know. The other ways. How? We should.
Look to other shelters across the country and see what they're doing.
Okay. So somebody already did it better.
Yes.
Okay, so that's.
New York City should do it better.
Absolutely. Okay. I think it's on the mayor again. Good morning.
What's your solution?
My solution is that we need to have people understand that all lives matter. We need to have respect for the animals and give them a chance. What they're doing is
we know this. We do, but we want the solution directly.
The solution is that they need to pay medical bills and treat the animals when on intake, because the animals are coming in healthy and they're getting sick in the shelter and they're selling the dead bodies because they make $400 or $500 for a dead body when they send it to the rendering plants.
But we live in capitalistic society. If you explain these things,
but we don't like that. We're not a capitalistic society. We're human rights society. Women don't think like that. You know how women think? All lives matter, and we're God's creatures, and we're supposed to protect God's creatures, and that's why we're here on Earth. And if we don't do that properly, they need to get out of that business and get people in that will do the right thing and to protect the animals.
I'm just playing the devil's advocate to provoke you even more.
My poor dog has two strains of kennel cough a year later that they couldn't treat it at the vet I paid a year for, and that dog came from animal care control 3 months old, and they were ready to kill it because it had kennel cough. And now she's 100 pounds, beautiful Rhodesian Ridgeback named Sheena.
What's her name?
Sheena. I'm Diane Signorelli.
Diane, you know how it was in my country a long time ago?
Where are you from? What country?
From Bulgaria.
Lovely Bulgaria.
Oh, what a beautiful start you have. Oh. In my country, there was nothing like this about the animals.
My girlfriend's in Bolivia saving animals.
Yeah, but this apparently is like only here this one happening.
No, this is all over the United States. I have New Jersey. We shut down a place called Hameta Regional Shelter for abusing animals. Advocates are everywhere, and everyone is making a change. And we need people to vote animal-friendly candidates so that they understand we, the people, we are stronger than the people in power. And if they don't,
I don't think so.
Yes,
I don't think so.
Yes, it is.
I want to joke with
people. It's stronger than the people in power.
I just want
to. And we need everybody to understand and vote animal-friendly election, please.
But I want to ask you this: do you know who are the particular people that are in charge for these decisions right now?
Right now, it's the mayor.
The mayor.
And Department of Health. And Risa Winstock, she is the director of Animal Care Control, New York City. 125 Word Street. That's the Department of Health building. That's where you go.
And why she's not here, by the way? Why she's not here?
Because she's hiding, because she knows she's a very mean, evil person. And she's making all the animals suffer. And she doesn't even take care of their health needs. They don't feed them. And if you don't believe me, go visit any shelter and see what they do.
I want to go in her house and to see if she has a cat or a dog.
Probably not. She's too evil.
I like that.
Call me sometime.
Okay,
my card. What's your name?
Ivan.
Diane.
I have my own channel, the most stupid channel in YouTube, but it's not popular.
I have friends that have radio shows. There's a lot of people who have radio shows.
I see. Okay, I think.
That's what I'm saying. If you want to be on Facebook, be my friend.
I don't want to be on Facebook. I'm just joking.
No, be my friend.
Listen, I think they should be found. The people that are in the decision has to. You gotta face them.
They have to be held accountable. They have to be held accountable for their actions. It's called animal abuse. And we have a big class action lawsuit against them, and we're never going to stop until they pay for what they did. And this is what we're saying. They had $100 million. They received $50 million from...
I like that. $50 million.
That's $50 million they got from Petco. $50 million they got from their.
Wait.
They got $100 million.
Why the Petco is paying for these people?
Because they must get something out of it, I guess.
For what? And they're the Petco in the business of selling food.
ASPCA gave them $50 million. So we're $100 million. They can't do nothing right.
Yeah, that's,
and I'll give you another good prime example. Staten Island's been trying to build an animal shelter.
Wait a minute.
For 5 years, and they can't even friggin' get it built. What the hell? We should get Trump. Trump could build it faster.
Correct, but that's not about Trump today.
Call Trump, build the animal shelter, Staten Island, New York. Department of Health, gotta go.
I think Diane said something very right, that they didn't do anything right, but what I think they did. They did something right. They got all these $15 million and $100
million. No, well, 50 and 50 is $100 million.
Yeah, that's the right thing.
We could do a lot of good. $100 million. Yeah. Somebody put it in their pocket. They probably got a Swiss bank account.
They do.
It's not in Heil Holland, right? The bank account's not in the Swiss bank account's not in Holland, right?
So of course.
Got a Swiss bank account. Yeah. He's from Bolivia. She's from Holland.
Who? What's that girl?
Yeah. She's from Holland.
Married then? Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, now I am here as I have my own channel in YouTube.
Yeah.
It's very not good channel, but I want to ask the reason for the protest. The reason for the protest is what the solution?
Well, there is not the solution is that they stop killing the animals.
That is not the solution.
The solution is build another shelter.
Mary.
Build another shelter.
One of the, yes.
Yeah, build another shelter. Keep the kennels clean so they don't get sick.
Okay.
People who love animals in there to work.
To go take care of the animals. That's a good solution. So they have to build another shelter in?
Yeah, they have to build another shelter because where the dogs and cats are held are in the basement.
Wait a minute. I just want to ask you this. Where these dogs come from to begin with?
Yeah, there are people dumping them. But that happens all over the world.
But why people would dump them?
Because of the mayor. He has a ban on...
Wait. You're confusing me now big time. I ask why people are dumping the animals.
Yeah, I'm telling you. The mayor issued a stop on certain kind of bees and the size of the bees.
This is very important.
Let's hear what she will say. What she is saying. What is she saying?
That's one of the reasons that they are justified killing these animals. Okay, everybody? We've got to protest as many times as we need to and vote out the people who are not giving money to keep these animals alive. Give them a chance, okay?
You also need to show up at the board meeting, okay? And be a friend.
Ah, that is a solution.
Show up to the board meeting. Let them know what they go for what?
The board meeting. I think that's where we have to go.
We're going to wrap it up. It's 5 o'clock. I want to thank everyone for coming.
Yeah!
I will continue to do what I got to do with all you guys.
Nice meeting you.
We all need each other's support.
Yes.
I want to thank the NYPD for looking after us.
Well, I see. Okay, now we gotta go in a place of serenity and peace, which is called Central Park. There's a lot of animals here. Nobody is chasing them. A friend of mine told me yesterday, hey, do you know, did you see? I said, what? And he say, I saw an eagle attacking a pigeon in Central Park. And I told him, hey, there's no eagles here. It's another type of bird, whatever. So now we are going in a place of serenity to, I have to comment on the questions that I asked. And it looks to me, all we gotta do is to blame the mayor, to blame the mayor, blame the evil people that took 100 million and whatever. Yeah, and that is all true. Of course, it is true. That's no doubt. However, when I asked the right question, which is, was what is the solution, it was again pointed to the mayor. Even when I ask another question, but wait a minute, where all these animals come from? Well, people dump them. And when I ask why people dump them, because of de Blasio, because of de Blasio, because of, yes. Maybe people dump their animals because of de Blasio, but we don't know. We have to investigate more on that. Oh, such a long pause. Well, I want to hear your opinion about the animals. I'm not against these guys. I'm not on the left side. I'm not trying to fuck around them and to make jokes and to make fun of them. But it seems to me that they are a bit confused, or they don't have a agenda. They are just here, well, just to express their feelings. And it's obvious they feel very angry. They feel bad. They feel bad for the animals. Yeah. Well, when I hear these type of people, when they talk about the animals, I'm like deeply troubled. Because it's just my fucked up way of thinking. I'm sorry. A lot of people tell me that I'm crazy. But, well, just look around. This is Central Park. Central Park. I can't... If you see this building over there, that's a Trump Tower over there behind the tree. I'm not gonna show it to you because I'm lazy to move. But, okay, let's move and show you. And show you here. Let me give you a little bit of understanding, like Jordan Maxwell would say, understanding about the world you live in. So here we go. This is called Central Park here. It's well, I'm gonna speed up now to get to the beauty. There is a beauty in the Central Park. Well, and there is a lot of running people against me. Opposite direction. I'm always going opposite direction. I'm sorry for my behavior again. Oh, I'm not actually. This is like, there's not too much rules in Central Park. Generally just go this way, but for people like me, go anyway. I mean, like, go all directions. Omni antenna. Well, I'm speeding up so much too. Some angry fuckers are telling me that I'm wrong. And of course I'm wrong. But I don't give a fuck about this people. Anyway, I respect them. I give them appraisal. Oh, you see, that is Central Park. And around Central Park, I have a feeling they are building a wall of a 50 to 70 or 80 story buildings. Soon Central Park will be like a little green square and you will see the walls. Now, check this out in the background. You see that building over there, like 50 to 60 story. Soon it will be bought from the Chinese mafia. I'm not joking about these things. But let me get back to the original thought of the animals. The animals. You see? Now look around. Animals on pedicabs, animals on walking animals, animals in the sky. Do you see them? Yeah, animal in front of you. See that? Well, you will say, why you call people animals? Well, good point. Very good point. Well, let's get back to my original idea. In the most prosperous country, in the most prosperous country in the world, United States of America, people talking about animal rights, this rights, this right. There is even one crazy guy that is talking about the toilet. Nobody is listening to him though, but soon will. But let's get back to the original question. Now, when people do care so much about the animals, why do they not care about the people? Does that sound strange? Or what are the priorities, the people or the animals? I don't know, some like this woman will say, all creatures living has a right to live, and yes, and we should not kill them. Yes, yes, that is correct. I'm not debating that, neither. No, I'm not opposing that idea. But, well, I think we gotta check our priorities first. You know, there is human rights, there is animal rights, there is all kinds of rights. But as a human being, what's your prioritization? That's a personal question to you. What are you gonna take care of first? Well, simple mathematical question. You have a dying dog and a dying person. They're nobody to you. The dog is not your sister, nor the person is your brother. So what are you gonna do? And let's say God tells you, well, you gotta make the right choice. Do the right choice. One here is killing, the other one is killing, and you have to save the one. Just one. Well, I don't know how to answer this question, so that's why I'm gonna close this video. But that's a good question. Who are you gonna save? The cat that is not your sister? Or the man, or the girl, or the guy, or the woman that is not your brother? Yeah. And don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe. This time you will have to subscribing. I don't know what that means, but whatever it Google invented, subscribed. Thank you.